Hey everyone, and welcome back to BMX News. This is a weekly BMX news show where I talk about everything that happened in the previous week within the world of BMX that I think you guys might care about. That being said, we've got a couple things to highlight first. The very first thing that I'm going to talk about, I'm only talking about once because I really don't care about this at all, but I had a few people asking about it, so here you go. The whole half cab controversy, where Steve Caballero, the guy who invented the half cab or whatever he did 40 years ago on a skateboard, says that only a skateboard can do a half cab because it requires an ollie, blah blah blah, whatever, BMX bikes don't do half cabs because they don't ollie, blah blah blah. Here's my take on the whole thing, and it makes it really quite simple. Skateboarding, BMX, half cab, two different sports, two different tricks, same name. Just because it was inspired by skateboarding doesn't mean that it's exactly the same trick. It's just a similar trick with the same name. Two different sports with two potentially different tricks that look very similar with the exact same name. It's pretty simple and I really don't care. Next week, this is gonna be last week's news, so let's just move on. After that, I wanna talk about the Free Knight Planetary Free Coaster. This one's been talked about quite a bit recently. Last week, I talked about how it's now available, and this week, they've dropped a video of the internals. It looks like it uses a clutch disc similar to other Free Coaster cassette designs. I honestly have no idea what I'm looking at. Like I said last week, I'm not a machinist. I'm not an engineer. I don't have any idea what this stuff means. So if you guys watch this video and you understand what's going on and you feel like typing a whole bunch, can you explain it in the comments to me? And if you don't want to, that's fine too, because I'm actually going to have a hands-on with this Free Coaster here as soon as it gets here. And that's it for highlights this week. So let's move into the rest of the news, which there is a lot of. That's why I'm talking pretty fast. The first thing is we have one piece of sponsorship news. This comes from Volume, and it's a quick clip welcoming Markel Jones to Volume. And that clip is 30 seconds long with two angles of him doing a handlebar height flat rail tooth hanger. Pretty sick, and I'm excited to see more from Markel in the future. After that, we've got some contest and jam highlights videos to talk about. The first is the Nowhere Corn Hucket Jam 2019 highlights video, and the second is the Battle of Hastings 2019 qualifier video. First, I want to talk about the Nowhere video. Nowhere is a company who is doing so much for BMX directly within their community and spreading positivity within the sport as a whole. And I feel like they just don't get the recognition that they deserve from greater BMX media. It seems like they kind of just brush over this thing that is like a family-friendly version of Swamp Fest that literally anyone is allowed to come out to any time of the year. And I'm not really sure why. Maybe it's because Nowhere isn't a paying sponsor for these websites, but either way, check out their Corn Hucket Jam highlights video from this year, because this event is enormous and it could be so much bigger if the greater BMX media community got behind it. And then the Battle of Hastings qualifier highlights video is awesome too. It starts out with kids on 16-inch bikes absolutely shredding the bowl at Source Park, and then it goes into some insane riding that you might have already seen highlights of on social media. And if you want to check out this or anything else that I have talked about or will talk about today, links are in the description below in the order that they're talked about, and that's the last time I'm mentioning the links. And that brings us into the videos from this week. The first one that I want to talk about is Brock Rayford's Walkways video from Odyssey, and I'll let you know what I think as soon as I watch it. All right, I know you guys are busy and I could talk all day long about BMX videos, but I'm gonna try and keep it short. Brock Rayford's Walkways video is an absolute must watch. As the title obviously says, it's an entire video based around walkways and sidewalks, and every single clip is amazing. A couple that stood out to me was that there was two flat rails close together with probably a foot or 2 foot gap between them. He does a crank arm grind, gap to crank arm grind on them, and just the way that his bike bounces, it just looked so satisfying. And then you could just see how insanely high Brock can bunny hop in some of these clips, because he's riding setups that most other people legitimately couldn't ride because they couldn't hop high enough to get to them. You have to watch this video if you're not one of the 37,000 people who already have. From there, we're going to take a trip to a world of BMX that any of you young kids watching probably have no idea exists, to Clint Miller's 45th birthday session video. And I just put together that this was probably filmed in one session, considering the title. And if you watch this video, it's amazing all of the stuff that just went down in one session, especially the last clip. That one's on my mind because I just watched it. A foof to ice to overtooth back over on a double coping spine. If you watch this video and you don't know that much about tech brake riding, just know that that trick was so hard to do, and he made it look super easy. So maybe it wasn't hard for him, but just know that it is extremely hard for anyone who might want to try it. I think my favorite part of this video was the first clip. He started out with a flatland trick, then he grinded a rail, then he did a jumping trick in a 360 over a jump, then he grinded another rail, and then he ended it with a gap from a kicker to a double peg grind on his double coping spine. So he did flat, street, a jumping trick, and then a lip park trick all in one clip, all those disciplines. And if he had a vert ramp, he'd probably do a vert trick in it too. This is a video that deserves way more attention than it's getting. Not to mention that this dude turned 45 the day that this video happened, and he's doing some good burly stuff in it too. So we went from California street on sidewalks all the way to Australia at Clint Miller's house. Now we're going up to New York with Cam Gervin and Zach Beerley, where they shut down the East Coast street. If you weren't into the first two videos that I talked about and you like street riding, this is the one for you, and you have to check it out. There's so much dialed riding in this one, and they do some big stuff and some tech stuff, and then they feature some locals that they encountered throughout the video. And it was just a very well done video that had a great soundtrack that went with the East Coast vibe, and I enjoyed it very much. And that's the last video I want to talk in depth about. As always, there's a bunch more to talk about. The first is Mike Gray After Dark from Haro. Then we've got Calvin Kosovich's Ride BMX Headlights section that went up this week. We've got Albie Bennett's Bone Death Too Fast for Food DVD section. And then we had two longer videos to talk about. The first is the Columbus, Ohio BMX Mixtape number 6. This one's something like 12 minutes long. And then we had a 20-minute video with Trey Jones giving a tour and show and tell day of his mid-school BMX museum at his house. And that brings us to the bike checks from this week. The first is a Chase Plaza video bike check from Standard, and the second is a Ty Morrow photo bike check from Iqla. And then that brings us to the products from this week. The first thing here is a video with Kareem Williams building up his signature S&M frame. I get the vibe from this video that is a split signature frame between him and Dave Crone. Not totally sure, but I'm sure that we're going to find out soon. And then we had a video with Hobie Doan, and it's called Hobie Doan Rides Kink CST Forks. This one has Hobie talking about the Kink CST Forks in general and why he rides them, and then it features some riding. But one interesting thing that he pointed out was that the investment cast allows for more clearance, so that whenever he does tooth hangers on aluminum rails or Smith grinds, it doesn't catch on any steel. And that brings us into the interview section from this week. The first thing here is another Polliver Pog cast that Chris Doyle runs, this time with Jerry Bagley. I haven't had a chance to listen to this one yet, but I have heard that it's very good. Then we had a video where Ride UK sat Dennis Anderson down and made him pick 3 tricks that he would do for the rest of his life if he could only pick 3 tricks. Then they made him pick 3 spots that he would ride for the rest of his life if he could only pick 3 spots. And then they made him pick 3 riders that he would ride with for the rest of his life if he could only pick 3 riders. This is a good one, and it feels like Dennis put some serious thought into this one. After that, we had a video in the new Mongoose Heritage series. It's with Nikita Dekaros, and this is legitimately one of the best and most well-made BMX videos that I have ever seen as far as the actual skill and video production value goes. Is basically, it's a documentary about Nikita talking about her history and the fact that she was born in Switzerland and just all this different insight that you probably haven't heard before, all in this amazingly well done package. As someone who is a video professional, I can't help but praise this one for how great it was done. And then next, we've got kind of a similar video to the last one, but this one comes from Monster in their Monster Mentality series with James Foster. He talks a little bit about himself and his history of BMX, and then he goes into talking about X Games and Big air and how he won the X Games gold. I think it was last year. This one is another one that was very well made, and the last part of this and the last things that he says in this video are something that I think that every BMX rider should hear. And that wraps it up for this week. If I missed anything, let me know. And if there's anything that I talked about that you want to comment on, do so in the comments down below. If you're new, hit the subscribe button. I come out with news videos just like this one every Friday, tips and tricks videos on Tuesdays, and other types of riding videos and streams throughout the week. I want to thank you guys for being here and watching, and we'll see you next time for another video. Goodbye.